Also, I don't know how, but I'm giving out this pepperoni meat stick. So you guys are a lucky audience to have a chance to win this. I didn't know bringing pepperoni meat sticks was optional. I'm a little bit upset about that. I'm Linda Ballantyne, and this is my last day in Boston. And I have loved this town to death. And I wish that I had a whole other week that I could just walk around and say wicked awesome and stuff like that. You guys have been awesome. Thank you so much.
Hi there. My name is John Stalker, and that's my pepperoni stick. Hey, I get it. This is my last panel here as well, because I think it is the last panel. And I want to thank you all sincerely for being really a great group of people, from you guys up to the coordinators and all the staff. You've made it as close to perfect as perfect can be for both me and my wife, and I want to thank you sincerely.
Hey guys, I'm Toby Proctor. I play Tuxedo Mask. My stripper name used to be Pepperoni Stick. So that's something. That's really crazy, but fun way. Yeah, and this is my last time. This is my first time in Boston. I've had the best time ever in Boston. I'm taking an accent with me home. And you guys were amazing. The staff has been amazing, and I would love to come back.
Hi guys, my name's Josh Greeley, and I donated my pepperoni stick to a Harry Potter cosplayer that needed a wand. It's long gone now. Hopefully they've got some good use out of it. This has been fantastic. This is my second time here in Boston and at Anime Boston, and it's just as good, if not even more so, than it was the last time I was here. I think it was 2009. So thank you guys so much for just being you and for being so gracious and so welcoming to all of us, and also to the staff for taking such good care of us. Greg Ayers sends his apologies. He had to go off site for something, so he will not be in this panel, but he sends his love, and he said he will see you all at the closing ceremonies. So, thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Matthew Mercer, voice of Leon Kennedy and Captain Levi.
I'm Kyle Hebert, and I voiced everything from Dragon Ball Z up to Attack on Titan, so I'm in Boston for my first time, and hopefully not my last, because you guys are incredible. This is a well-oiled machine of a convention. This, the staff and the fans, everything, it is like the perfect storm. The storm of awesome. So thanks so much. I gotta echo everyone's sentiments here. You guys rock.
Favors the bold.
Definitely shy. Make me go.
Thank you, Cristina.
Kyle and for Cristina.
Oh,
this great new portal of content, user-generated content, so we can present material in a new way and introduce a new audience. I mean, I'm sure there's people that have never even watched Dragon Ball Z. Now, because they had such a great time laughing at the abridged version, now they're going to seek out the original. So, yeah, I think it's a win-win for everybody. It's hilarious.
Because she is so, I think they're very similar in that they've been through like traumatic experiences. experiences, so they end up being kind of deadpan, but they're not really, because there's so much going on underneath. I would not like to be her, because she has suffered too much. And she, you know, she snaps, and it's such a fun character.
My favorite animation character would be Wicked from Cyber Chase. Who is the insane witch? She's an insane witch who is one of the villains in it, and she just thinks she is so great. Well, hacker, look at me! Or better still, yeah, look at me. She's just a lot of fun, and her love interest is Christopher Lloyd, who plays hackers.
My favorite character goes back to my very, very early days. And that is Beastly.
Yes.
And I think Beastly will probably outlive me. Because Care Bears still runs to this day. Then I guess I do a little Beastly.
Yes, no hurt. I mean, no, yes, hurt. I mean, I don't know what I mean.
Who's kidding who? Tuxedo Mask is my favorite. I say this all the time. I get to be tall, dark, and handsome, and I get to be a boyfriend to a blonde.
More specifically, me.
Yeah, and I like shrubbery, apparently.
It's really hard to choose. There's so many characters that have all been announced in the last play. Akihisa Yoshigamaka and Test is also been one of my favorites. But in terms of, I really like challenging roles, and I would have to say that so far, one of the most challenging that I've had would be Armin in Attack on Titan.
Being filled up with so much energy and so much love that it just makes you go
clowns who give you meat sticks.
I was seriously considering if the meat stick wasn't gone to ask Christina to go deep and have a run and catch it.
I now have
a series and I had to read for a living. And it was my biggest fear in life. And it helped, this series helped me overcome that because I literally had to read for the job. And I have no education. I don't have high school. And it doesn't matter. It's great to have an education. I think you should always stay in school if you can. And my specific area of life at that point, I was already in the business. I was getting a better education in the world, but it doesn't matter. And if you can get an education as well, do it. But don't let anybody ever put you down for it.
It's largely the fact that what you bring to the performance is the reason you'll be there. The training and your schooling will help that. You know, anything you learn, any classes you take will inevitably help give you a more strong performance, but it's not something you should be or will be judged on. It's purely what you bring to that audition. So.
So, in a similar vein, what got you into voice acting, and what do you have to suggest for anybody aspiring to become a voice actor?
Do you mind if I start off with something here? How about we do this? By show of hands, how many people in here have an interest in becoming a voice actor or just an actor in general? Okay, keep them up. Out of all of you, how many have had either formal theater training or have performed in either community theater, high school theater, college theater? That's awesome. You're already on the right track. It really is really all about the experiences, like getting the experience and continuing to learn. Once you get to a point where you say, I think I know enough, you've shot yourself in the foot. Never stop pursuing and never stop refining your art. You always have to keep going for it. And it's also about persistence and having a good attitude, being easy to work with. And unfortunately, in a lot of time, a lot of ways, you have to be where the work is. So if you want to be in it, if you want to voice anime in the US, that means you have to go to either LA, New York, Dallas, or Houston, or go to Canada and work at that in Toronto. That's pretty much it that I can say, but really just it's all about continuing to be persistent into it and finding your art. Anybody?
I'd say also you've got to get used to the word no and do not take it personally. Because if you're not right for the role, you're just not right for the role. But you are going to hear no a million times more than you're going to hear yes. And we work a lot, all of us work quite a bit. And I hear the word no every week, I don't even know how many times. I hear it a lot more than I hear the word yes, that's for sure. So it's going to knock you down and knock you down and knock you down, and you just keep getting up. And if you get to a point where you go, I don't want to get up anymore. This is killing me. I don't want to hear this anymore. Then it's okay to say, I don't want to do this. Because it's not for everyone. It's a really tough slog. It really is.
Remember also, if you're continually being called to audition, even though you're not getting the gigs, but those people in sort of at that particular casting level are calling you back and calling you back, you've got some. Really, the difference between you and the person that gets it is the fact that that person's voice better suits the production. If they call you back, you've got something, and the yeses will come. Okay? It shows you got the jobs. If you go out a couple of times, and you don't get called back, and your agent puts forth the question, he needs more work, she's not quite there, that's the signal to you to continue to work and jump in again later.
And then what got you guys into voice acting?
Mel playing for me.
Yep.
Growing up on Warner Brothers cartoons and all those classic animated bits, just my entire childhood was based around those cartoons and the idea that one person could produce so many characters. That was just a fascinating aspect. Like I did my fourth grade biography report on Mel Blanc. They were also doing George Washington and Abraham Lincoln. I guess they're important too, but I mean, honestly. So growing up with animation and just loving what's done there was perpetual inspiration to want to be part of that.
I grew up during the Disney Renaissance of the 90s, and So I loved animation. I thought I was going to be an animator. And this is kind of, you know, it's really funny because here I am sitting next to Sailor Moon, and this is the show that got me, who, that made me want to be a voiceover actor. So, yeah. So, you know, for all the no's that you hear, it's the moments like these where it's like, all right, I'm doing something right because I've gotten this far, and seeing you guys come to the panels and say hi to me, and it just, you know, it's wonderful, and I'm so thankful to be here. So thank you guys.
No, where are you guys, right?
Well, like, we're just like,
just like us.
Watch cartoons and go, oh my God, I love that, and do the stupid voices when we're at home and imitate people. And we still do that. I drive along in my car every day, and I'm hearing the radio commercial, and I'm doing exactly what they're clean and under control or something like that. And I'm just imitating whatever they do because those are the people that are working right now. And if they're doing it and you can sound like them, then you're halfway there, aren't you? So just keep doing it. We're you guys.
Thank you.
I would think that Character Ultron.
Your room is like sure is quiet now.
Yeah, but Ben asked the doctor about something. Of course, there's a present.
Yes.
Just tell your mother to call me. I'll talk to her.
Thank you so much for your question. There are a lot of other people that are waiting, so, but thank you so much.
Hello. As you can see, Sailor Moon shirt.
Love the shirt.
I have a comment first before my question. I just want to thank all of you up on stage here because there was a tragedy in my family, and my brother actually died. I know it's morbid, kind of thing. This is October. I'm still kind of grieving through it, and his birthday would actually be tomorrow. But I just want to thank you guys for helping me lift up kind of my spirits and getting through it. But anyway, my question is, outside of voice acting, what do you guys like to do?
I love reading. I love books. I'm always reading. Even, yeah, that's it.
Apparently I'm reading because I can't talk. Apparently.
I'm sorry to hear about your brother, and I think I speak for everyone in saying that the thing for us is meeting people like you, and it is very rewarding to hear you say that our voices have in some way led to your happiness, and happy birthday to your brother. And I like to do yoga.
I love running, but in Canada we've had the worst winter of my entire existence. Yeah, so I'm not running through snow, so I'm just a little pig right now, a little slovenly pig. But I swear, as soon as that snow melts, I can start running again.
Where
are
you from,
Canada? Toronto, eh?
In the country. I'm a country boy. I've been for over 20 years. I have a 13-acre wooded property, and I am a fanatical landscaper and rock mover and woodcutter and anything physical that takes me to the other extreme that my profession is, which is basically cerebral, is great with me. So being really seriously physical is my passion.
I'm a father to three young children, five, three, and one, and I just love being a father.
That's really cute.
I like being taller than people too, so it really helps.
Anything that can keep my mind busy, I like to, like, I'll switch back and forth. I like to read, I like to draw, avid gamer. Sometimes I like to multitask and do many of them at the same time. So, similar way, keeping the brain busy. Gaming whenever possible. I actually have been running both the 4th edition Dungeons & Dragons and Pathfinder game for the past 3 or 4 years. I'm an avid tabletop gamer and pretty much a direct DM GM for the past 15 years. So big nerd.
All things geeky, man. I love movies. I love comics. I love games. Just whatever can keep my attention. I'm really hitting. What up? Shiny? You know?
Squirrel.
Right. Squirrel!
Thank you.
Hello there, friends. First off, I just want to thank you for making basically anime possible with your voices from Sailor Moon to now our new Attack on Titan. So I thank you for that. And my question is, what is your most memorable experience?
The one that instantly comes to mind is when I almost destroyed a microphone. I was working at a Sentai Filmworks in Houston, Texas, and I had just come in, driven all the way from Dallas. It was about a 5-hour drive that morning, and I had stopped at Sonic on the way in and got their stuff, like a Route 34 or iced tea. And I was sitting in the booth, and I think we were recording. I can't remember what we recorded, but it was a very physically active character. I was just going.
was tea coming out here, and I turned it over, there was tea coming out of the studio, and I saw this, and I woke up, and I just started freaking out, and I knocked the microphone over, and so we ended up losing an hour of recording because we had to clean everything up, find a new microphone. Yay.
I wanted to ask this yesterday to the ones that voiced the character on it.
character that you voice, which one's your favorite character?
Garrett, no!
It's a toss-up between Sasha and Hanji. It would almost have to go to Hanji because she's being voiced by in the dub by Jessica Cabello, who played Excel in Excel Saga, and that was one of my first big anime loves. So it was super cool that I get to play alongside her.
I'm probably going to have to go with Sasha, personally. She cracks me up, and in one of those strange circumstances, my friend Ashley Birch back in LA is playing her in the new dub, and it's kind of one of those unrelated circle closing points on that, so it was a perfect casting choice for that character, and I'm really excited to see it, so.
I think we only have time for one more question, guys. Sorry.
Thank you for your question.
Yay!
Hello.
Hi!
How are you? So, I just wanted to say real quick that the Sailor Moon guys, thank you so much, because that's pretty much what brought me into, like, anime, like, when I was, like, six, like, running home to watch Toon Boom. I was like, yeah, Sailor Moon! So, just wanted to get to that. And also, my birthday was Friday, so...
Happy birthday!
As quickly as I can, but if it takes a while, please just be patient. That will get to you.
say what they are, but I have about three or four new anime coming out that should be announced hopefully within the next couple of months, and a video game. And one thing I can talk about is that my first ever original animation project being over here in the States called Owl Glories. I'm playing a very evil, dastardly owl named Deborah, so be on the lookout for new ones. You can follow me at Matthew Mercer on Twitter. Please do, because I have some cool announcements coming up soon. I'm excited about a couple anime projects and a bunch of video game projects. And also, those of you who are playing Infamous Second Son, you can listen for me as Tanner Black. So keep an ear out for that. And also later, towards the very end of this year, a series of fantasy films, a trilogy of fantasy films called Mythica. I play the lead villain, Sorlok, the Necromancer. So look for that. At Kyle Hebert on Twitter, you can hear me as various soldier, militia, background stuff in Titanfall, and obviously Attack on Titan. How confusing is that?
Yeah.
As we to be in episodes 10 through 13. And Tekkai Nights on Cartoon Network on Saturday mornings, and Digimon Fusion on CW. So hope to see you guys online.
Enjoy the rest of the conference.